Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do some amazing foil transfer things on nails. Just keep watching. So Andrea's already got a set on when we did the marble ombre set. We filled them, reshaped them a little bit, and we're going to use this set and change it by using foil and gel polish, obviously. We're going to be using this colour. So it's 594. It will have a name. Not sure what it is. And I'm going to cover all the nails apart from the ring finger. So I'm going to coat, no, actually, I just said to you, I'm not going to coat the ring finger. I am going to coat the ring finger as well. I'm going to give all of these nails a gorgeous coat of this colour.
Peacockalicious, aren't we, call it?
Peacockalicious, I love it! What a cool name! And I will do two coats of colour. I need the true colour and I need lots of coverage because obviously we've already got the marble and we don't want the marble to show through. Peacockalicious. If it isn't called Peacockalicious, I think Naio Nails should change the name.
You think?
Yeah. Pop me those in. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to top coat the thumb, this finger, I'm going to miss the ring finger and I'm going to top coat that. Because we're going to be using the transfer foil glue, I don't want there to be any stickiness on the nail because I only want the foil to stick to the transfer foil glue and nothing else. So it's important to seal the nail first. Even if you wipe off this, you can wipe off the sticky layer, but this is foolproof. So you know you're not going to have any sticky layer because this top coat has no sticky layer. Whereas you could wipe off the sticky layer from the coloured gel polish and maybe you haven't got it all off and then your foil sticks to that and it messes up your design. One other thing that happens when you wipe over the gel polish to take off the sticky layer is you lose a little bit of colour as well. So this is just a better way to do it, I feel. Pop that in the lamp. So this is the foil that we're going to use. And it's like a beautiful little ombre. Look at that. It feels so pretty. Nice, I have hair like that.
Yeah. Until you washed it once.
Yeah. And then it all went away. Right, so we're going to cut some of this off. These are my really rubbish scissors, clearly. I've got some really good ones, but I don't know where they've gone. These are really good scissors. I'll use them next time. They're not the ones I was on about for. They look really good scissors. So I'm going to use the foil glue transfer gel. And we're doing this. I've never done it before. And I want to see if there's any problems with it. And we'll... And I'll talk to you and see how we can rectify them and help you. Because we've been asked many times, can you do a full nail of foil with the foil glue? And we don't know. So we can find out. And Andrea is our guinea pig. So I'm going to make sure I cover all the nail. Oh, drip. You weren't on drip watch then, Adam.
Sorry.
Adam normally goes drip. I think this is one of the most important things, is to get the entire nail covered with the foil gel. Pop me that in the lamp. While that's in the lamp, I'm going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution on this side. So the matte side, we're going to wipe over and just clean that. It gives you a better transfer. Ooh, I feel a bit nervous. Bring it here. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
The only thing is, the transfer foil is not the same shape as the nail, because the nail is curved and the transfer foil is a flat object. Does that make sense? So that's where you're going to run into trouble. So that's what we'll have to rectify. So let's just snatch that. Oh, it's not that bad, you know. So you can see the curviest part of the nail is where you tend to have a little bit of trouble. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a clean part and make sure I go right to the edges, see if we can just transfer a little bit more. I want the ombre to be the same. Oh yeah, it's starting to cover, look. Imagine if I use this part, it wouldn't look the same, you see. So I want to make sure I'm using the right colour in the right part. I'm just going to stretch that around the cuticle. Oh, I tell you what. That worked, didn't it? That was good. Now we need to get this area here. So I'm just going to use my nail to sneak down there. See if we can fill that bit. Smidge more. Look at that, it's working, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So yeah, I've had to go over it a few times just to get those little bits that may have not quite stuck the first time around. But I really think that is just down to the fact that it's different curves. Right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to seal that. Because if you don't cap the entire thing, the entire nail, not the thing, what are we on, Stranger Things? If you don't cap the entire nail, then it'll come off. So you need to make sure you cap the end, and you need to make sure you let that brush just scoop around the edges, and then pop me that into the lamp. I'm impressed, I'm happy. Was a little bit nervous, not gonna lie. Yeah, so when you put the foil glue on, because it's so sticky, it's perfect
For the just foil, grabbing it.
For just grabbing it, yeah. But if you didn't seal it, it'd scrape off.
Ah, right.
You have to seal it.
Ah.
So gel residue wipe-off solution, and we can just wipe off anything that's on the skin, or even on my fingers. I'm quite impressed. Are you impressed, Adam?
It looks good. I like the colours.
Yeah. So the next stage of this design is we are going to use the foil glue again. We're not doing a full nail. We are going to do these gorgeous little kiss lips on Andrea's nails. Like that. Like somebody's kissed you with ombre lipstick.
Yeah.
Now that'd be good. So I've put some on some backing paper from Sculpting Foam. And then Adam's going to love filming there.
Because he can't see anything.
Because I can't see a thing. And we're just going to do basic lip kiss shapes. And you want to sort of do this with line, sort of little liney movements. What I'll do is I'll complete one nail so you can see exactly what I mean. The main bit you want to get right is this Cupid's bow section of your lips. If you don't know what that is, that's that bit there. That little Cupid's bow. And then you want to just do these little lines as if they are the little creases from the lips. Because when you go like that, you get these little creases. Maybe not me as much.
You've got them, yeah.
Yeah. Didn't know the filler was filling it out.
I was going to say, she'll be off now. Oh no, I've got creases in my lips. I'm going to get them filled.
Pop me that in the lamp. So I'm gonna place on top, and I'm gonna rub where I've done the lips. Rub that foil on. Oh, I like this one. This one not so much, because part of the foil has come off that didn't need to. See that bit that's flaking off? That was... See how it's flaking off so easy? That's because there was no glue there. And there's a little bit of glue on that one. Still. Better. So because we top coated, see those little bit, they don't stick. They might come off, but they don't stick. They'll only stick where we actually put the glue. So what I'm going to do, we're going to top coat that. No, I'm not. Liar. I'm going to finish the rest. I'm going to do the lips on the other ones, and then I'm going to top coat, and we'll be back. So once I'm done, I'm just going to top coat all of them just to seal that in, make them nice and glossy. Them in the lamp. I'm going to take a soft buffer, and I'm just going to buff any sections that I'm going to put some stones. So I'm going to put some stones on those two, and some on the thumb. And I'm buffing because I want the Acrygel to stick really well to the nail. I've got some gel residue wipe off solution in my dampened dish, and I'll just pop a little bit of that on my brush, but I will take off the excess on to the paper towel. I'm just going to move this around, place it where I want it. So wherever I'm going to put them stones, that's where I will make sure I have my Acrygel. Acrygel is awesome for applying stones. It lasts such a long time. So we don't cure the Acrygel yet at all. We top coat. And this is also going to give that foil nail an additional top coat, which will hold the foil in place. And I'm going to bob some stones. I'm just going to press them into the Acrygel. I'm just going to put some micro beads in as well. I'm just going to pop some cuticle oil on to finish off. Now we've got a bit of bling. Let's rub that in. They're cool.
They are cool.
Yeah, I love them. They're like, you could just keep looking at them. Those are the colours, and I love the colour of them. Love, love, love. Kisses for me, save all your kisses for me. Bye bye, baby, bye bye. There you are, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and give it a go. Don't forget to tag us, hashtag Naio Nails. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. It's my baby. I'm going to get up and say, mach, 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 mach.